Good day, beloved. This is Pastor F. Kennard, Senior Pastor of the Ebenezer Missionary Baptist Church, and I greet each of you in the name of our precious Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Well, it is another day, another beautiful day that the Lord has made, and yes, we should rejoice and be glad in it. I pray that each of you, you and your families, of course, are doing well on today. Well, it is Thursday, and it's time for another Thursday's Task moment. Thursday's Task, which comes from our daily devotions that we have Tuesday through Friday. We have Tuesday's Thought, Wednesday's Wisdom, Thursday's Task, and of course, Friday's Fact. Well, for Thursday's Task, I simply want to give you this word. Do not lose your faith. Do not lose your faith. I have to say it again. Do not, whatever may happen in your life or whatever circumstance may arise, do not lose your faith. I know it's easy sometimes for us to live doubt or have doubt in our mind and sometimes believe that the things that we actually would have hoped to happen in our lives seem to take a little longer. We can begin to doubt sometimes and want to give up on what it is that God has called or God has preordained for us to have in our life. But I'm here to let somebody know, regardless of what it is that's going on in your life, you cannot afford to lose your faith. I'm reminded as we talk about Holy Week, and we're in the midst of Holy Week, and we know that Thursday is known as Maundy Thursday. Which means the washing or symbolizes the washing of feet for the poor. But we understand we're dealing at this point where Jesus is getting ready to have Passover, the last meal, the last supper with his disciples. He's getting ready to have this last meal. And he's reclining at the table, as we found out on Tuesday. He's reclining at the table and he says, I'm eagerly, right there in Gospel of Luke chapter 22, I'm eagerly desiring to be here with you. But Jesus, after having this moment with his disciples, begins to talk to them and begins to give them revelatory situations or events that are about to take place in their life. And he says this right in Luke chapter 22, verse 31 through 32. He says, listen, he says, Simon, Simon, talking to Peter, he says, Simon, Simon, Satan has asked for you. He has asked to sift you and the brothers as wheat. He wants to sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for you. I have prayed for you, Simon, that your faith, watch this, may not fail. That your faith may not fail. He says, when you turn back, when you come back, strengthen or encourage your brothers. He says, Satan has asked to sift you and the brothers as we. He's asked for you. However, Satan has asked to sift you. I have prayed for you. And when you turn around, strengthen your brothers. Do not let your faith fail you. And when you turn back to me, strengthen your brothers. Brothers and sisters, do not lose your faith. And we understand the moment that Jesus is talking here. Judas is already out doing what he was supposed to do, because in the text yesterday, we talked about Judas being necessary in our lives. And everybody has a Judas, regardless of whether you want to admit it or not. There's been somebody in your life that has helped propel you or motivate you to become who it is that you are today. And you're pressing and you're desiring to press forward simply because of that situation or that person that was in your life pushing you to that level. But on today, Jesus says, listen, Simon. He's talking to Simon because he realizes that Peter is going to have a great assignment ahead. He realizes that he has some things in store for Peter, and he needs to remind Peter that I need you to know that I've prayed for you because Satan has asked for you. Satan wants to sift you. He wants to separate you. He wants to fragment the thoughts in your mind, fragment the love in your heart. He wants to piece by piece tear you down so that you will lose your faith and you will begin to doubt in the things that I've called for you to do. He says, I want you to understand that I've prayed for you, that your faith will not fail you. But I love this. He said, but when you turn back, strengthen your brothers. In other words, God says, I know you may fail, but don't let your faith fail. And that's where I want to pitch my tent at today before I get ready to close out for today. I want to advise you that you are not called to live a perfect life, but you are perfecting every day. You are getting better each day. The stronger you grow in God's word, the more equipped, the stronger you'll become by living God's word. He says, listen, you may fall, but I don't want your faith to fall. In times we may get a little tired and we may get a little wearisome. We may go through a lot of trials and tribulations and things that may start to burden us or start to tear us down. But God is saying, even in your lowest moment, you may fall in that moment, but do not let your faith fall, because it is your faith that you will have left that will give you the hope to believe in something better than the current situation that you're in. Once again, we cannot allow our current situations or the things that are trying to detour us or distract us to get in the way of God's plans for our life, for the plans are still there. It's up to you, however, to stay the course. Do not let your faith fall. Do not lose your faith, beloved. I beseech you, do not lose your faith. faith, because God is getting ready to take that faith and restore in you what it is that you need so that you can be an encouragement to somebody else. He says, I need you to hold on to your faith, because the assignment for your life is much bigger than you, but it's going to impact those all around you. God is saying, if you can just hold on for a little while longer, keep that hope, keep that same motivation, keep that drive. Do not give up on his word, and God will deliver you into the very place that he has for you with your assignment on it. I'm praying for you. I love you guys, and I know that God's going to do great things in our life. Hey, we're almost there to the Super Bowl. I know tomorrow is Good Friday. Once we get to that point, we're going to understand that God is about to do something that has never been done before. He is going to bring his son back from the grave, and he's going to give him all the power that he needs to move in us, for us to do what it is that he needs for us to do. May God bless you, may God keep you, and may God give you the desires of your heart. I love you guys, and I will talk to you all soon. Have a blessed rest of the day. Bye-bye.